shoutoutradio.com. Tune in now for shout outs and requests. Call, WhatsApp, or SMS us on 0044 777 0603 264.
DJ Sin.
We got an interview right here with the one and only Little Shan Shan. Now, if you don't know, I'm gonna let you know in a minute.
I'm the man, girlfriend, luxury, I swim. Magadocious to the most, brown, sexy, slim. Set up trends, known for making dividends and millions of people. Jump.
To be the next step, get deleted by death. Undefeated, ain't no bang to put that body to rest. Chest filled with smoke, yo. By the collar, follow me cause my dollars making most sense than common. Robbing you for your money and your diamonds, endangering your species more than a woman like the BGs. No remorse, steady smoking Clinton. Let it go and let the brat commit to be the baddest.
Oh, baby, roll me a mic and let me smoke till I'm high. If you ever see me pop, then you know that I live and die for the things I do. Slang I use, breaking down mics and destroying crew.
Roll me a mic and let me smoke it till I'm high. If you ever see me rock, then you'll know that I live and die for the things I do. Slang I use, breaking down mics and destroying crews.
Y'all just about to see big parties, 12 until. See, I'm the daddy of the mechan at the top of the world. I chill, keep it real. My field of work consists of that and hugging. Saying where they keep it pissed. My life, I wouldn't trade it to me. It's nothing better waking up when I want a sporting J. Bugging at the autograph.
Bubble bath, 5-star hotel.
Rolling with a click, super thick, and everybody's getting
mail. Take off the safety and face, become powder chowder for real. The last figure to ever make it off the hill, but still, rhyme, rock, light, coke, and smoke. And I'm in effect with a tank that got an infrared scope. Smacking, those hacking, toughest to knacking. Fall up in your hood, increase your brain at the MAC 10. Stack in, 17s on the pin. And burn up by my thigh, case you find out.
Baby, roll me a mic and let me smoke till I'm high. If you ever see me rock, then you know that I live and die for the things I do. Slang I use, breaking down mics and destroying crew.
Roll me your mic and let me smoke till I'm high. If you ever see me rock, then you know that I live and die for the things I do. Slang on you, breaking down mics and destroying crews.
Oh, some men tell me we got it going on. We're turning your
is that so definite?
Is that so definite?
So we got Shan Shan in the building. This record that's playing right now, Criss Cross. Do you know this record? Do you know who Criss Cross is? Yeah, you've got to know who Criss Cross is.
Feel me? My whole thing is to get inside your body. I run game like my name was John Gotti. Hitting hook shots.
So if you locked in, we got Shan Shan live. She was runner up or something on The Voice UK, which is crazy. And she has already had such a journey since, to what, 13? You're 13 years old now? Oh, 11. She's had that much of a crazy journey already, and she's only 11 years old. We've got her live in the studio right here, as you can see. Go share it. If you guys got any questions for her, you can message in. And yeah, I hope we're going to get a freestyle as well. I don't know yet. But she's got this really cool thing here called Freestyle Fridays that she does. You can go check out on Instagram or YouTube. Is it on YouTube as well? Oh, it is. All right. Nice. So tell us. It's what? So far, it's just on Instagram. Okay. What is your Instagram, Little Shan Shan?
My Instagram is Lil Shan underscore Shan, spell LilShan underscore Shan.
So if you want to go and check out these Friday Freestyle Fridays, which is really cool because she's literally, she'll ham on half the rappers, man. Like, I don't care what anyone's saying, but this girl's lyrical and she's got skill. And the way she puts her wording on is just insane. So I know, I think it's dope. So I'm going to have a lot more coming from Miss Little Shan Shan. Like I said, she had come runner-up. Am I right?
Well, we don't... Well, sorry? Yeah, I got to the final.
She got to the final of The Voice UK, which, if you guys are outside the UK, which a lot of our audience are, The Voice UK is a
Voice Kids UK,
which is The Voice, is a contest in the UK for singers. Shan came and wowed everyone. Anyone can YouTube Little Shan Shan and go and check out what she did at The Voice UK and how she wowed everyone. Insane. So, Shan Shan, your experience on The Voice UK?
My experience on The Voice Kids UK was very, very good. But it was a bit of an up and down journey because I'm not going to lie, it was a lot to deal with, you know, like practicing all the time, getting the right, the correct stage presence and everything like that, and just trying to impress the crowd. It was a lot to deal with, but you know, I think it was all for the best in the end anyways. It gave me a lot of publicity and I just really enjoyed the experience also. Yeah,
that's what the main thing is about, enjoying the experience and making sure you learn, because this is literally a journey and you can't stop learning on this journey. And you're 11 years old, so just from 11 years old, you're doing things that most adults want to do, you know what I'm saying? And got to dreams that most adults don't even get to do. So what was the biggest thing you learned out of your journey at The Voice UK Kids?
The biggest thing that I learned was probably like how to, I've already been performing in front of people before The Voice Kids, but I definitely learned a lot more in terms of stage presence and performance wise, because normally before The Voice Kids, I had like kind of small performances where the stage it was kind of small. But yeah, the stage on The Voice Kids was just massive. I had so much space to move around. There was a lot of people there. So it really just made me, gave me a lot more experience with performing in front of a lot of people.
And you said about the, before you were saying about learning mic technique and all of that stuff, yeah? Those are the really professional things that most artists, even when they're coming to studios at age of 22 and things, they don't, haven't learned yet. What are those important aspects that you learn as an artist in your growth at such a young age?
Like, what exactly do you mean? I don't really understand.
Like, when you're live, you learn mic technique and presence, and you were talking about contrast and how you, you know, all of those kind of things.
Well, I learned that when you're like, since there's a lot of other kids that are performing, you need to stand out and do something that makes the crowd remember you. With me, on every performance, actually apart from the battles, I try to do a little gymnastics move, as I do like to do gymnastics. Like in the first round, I done the splits. The second round, I didn't do anything. But yeah, that was because it was more than one person performing with me. And on the semi-finals, I done a one-handed cartwheel. And on the finals, actually, I don't think I did a gymnastic move on the finals, but I did do a lot of dancing and bring a lot of energy. And considering the other kids were singing, I think I really stood out in terms of energy. Yeah.
So on that singing, and I think you're really talented because you do gymnastics, dancing, rapping. But what did it feel like being like the first rapper? I mean, the only rapper to be on like The Voice Kids UK, and knowing that everyone else is singing, they've got that one talent, you had to work that little bit extra harder, you know what I mean?
It actually made me feel really amazing, because with me, I'm a type of person that really likes to stand out. Like, I don't want to be like everyone else. I've always wanted to be very different. So for me, that was just another way that I could show my difference and how different I was to other people. Yeah, so
really, really cool. So you have a track that I'm going to play later on, which you have released. You've got a music video out there for it. It's really, really cool. Tell us about the music video experience, and is this your first music video you've done?
So I've actually done 3 other music videos, so it's not the first, but it's the first one that has been out on all digital platforms. Actually, 4 music videos. Yeah, so but it's the first one that's been on all digital platforms, which means I can get like loads of streams and stuff. It's, by the way guys, Sweet Tooth out now on all digital platforms, Spotify, Apple Music, everything. So make sure you go stream it. And yeah.
11 years old. I can't get over the fact that she's so articulate in the interview and she's 11 years old. You know what I mean? Like, that's brilliant. So make sure you go and get that. It's called Sweet Tooth. It's called Sweet Tooth. The video is out on YouTube. You can get it on Spotify, Apple Music, Tidal, and all the other good streaming platforms. So you met a couple of celebrities, obviously, on your journey on The Voice Kids. You met Jessie J, who was wowed by your talent. Was it Jessie J? Yeah, Jessie J. She interviewed Jessie J, by the way. Yeah, big up Anna in the building. Boop, 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 boop. So, Will.i.am, obviously, you met, and everyone else on the panel. So tell us a little bit about your experience working with these people at such a young age.
So mainly I did work with Will.i.am, as I did go on his team, but like I'll start with the others. So Jessie J was just like absolutely amazing. When I saw that all of the judges had turned around, I was very torn between Jessie J and Will.i.am, because I've been listening to both their music for so many years. It's just crazy. But I know that Will.i.am had my best interest. He's a rapper, I'm a rapper, so I related to him a lot more than Jessie J, I think. So that's mainly why I picked Will.i.am. But Will.i.am is just amazing. He's so down to earth. And as a famous person, you think, well, they might think, oh, I'm famous, I can't talk to nobody. But Will.i.am's really not like that. He's really nice, really kind, really down to earth. So yeah.
Nice. What about the other two? Did you get to meet them and do anything with them?
Pixie and Danny. I didn't really listen to their music like that. I still heard of them and knew who they were. But yeah, I did talk to them. They really like my music. They also turned around. But apart from that, yeah.
Okay, that's so cool. So what have you got coming up in your future? Like, have you got plans at the moment? Like, are you recording new music? Have you got any artists that you may be trying to feature with?
So I've got a lot of music coming out soon, so everybody stay tuned. So far, I'm just thinking of mainly working on myself and trying to boost my career. But I'm definitely interested in working with other artists, hopefully in the future. But first, I just want to work on myself a bit more. Yeah.
Nice. Got a big up 57 Dynasty one time in the house as well. If you don't know, one more time, get to know and go check out their music. Definitely got to go check out their music. Shanshan is kind of the daughter of one of the members of 57 Dynasty, which is really, really cool. And it shows like the music is traveling down the bloodline. Tell us, what made you start rapping in the first place? Like, what got you influenced in actually rapping and not singing and other things?
So interestingly, before I was a rapper, I actually was like really interested in singing, because my mum, she was a really, really great singer. But I think like I wasn't the best singer, not gonna lie. And I think I more had the tone for rapping. I was inspired by my dad. Big up my dad. He used to be in a rap group called the 57th Dynasty. That really just inspired me. I listened to his music all the time. My mum would play his music, and I just thought, you know, I really want to do this. You know, because I thought it would be a great career and I'll be following my dad's footsteps. So, yeah.
That's cool. You ain't a DJ if you ain't playing this. You can't rap. You can't scratch. You can't mix. Again, Tunda, we got to do a remix for that, yeah? Featuring me. That's coming out 2020. Oi, oi, oi. Making doors on the radio right now. We're going to even put little Shanshan on that. You know what I mean? Oi, oi. Are we doing it? So what are you excited about now in the future, since you're only 11 years old? You've got to the final of the Voice Kids UK. Like, you've got such a huge journey ahead of you. Like I said, most people at your age like haven't done what you've done at 25, 30. So what is the most exciting things you have, and give me an artist that you at one point in your career you want to try and feature with? Like, what's one you've got to say, yeah, I've got to make it, and I've made it if I featured with a song on this with this artist? Who?
So I actually listen to a lot of artists, like I'm a rapper, so of course, but I definitely think I want to feature with somebody maybe like YNW Melly. I really, really like him. I think he's an amazing artist and he's very inspiring to me, and he does like a lot of different styles of music, and I want to be like that. I want to be very versatile. He's very commercial. So yeah, I just really hope, you know. If not that, then Cardi B and Nicki Minaj. I definitely think their lyrical ability is amazing. But yeah.
You should not even be listening to Cardi B. What kind of nonsense is this? Like, wait. Why are you listening to Cardi B? Yo. Tunda, we have to call the parents in, you know, because I can't. Do you know what? The worst thing is, yeah, I'm looking at my whole playlist and I'm thinking, I have an 11-year-old child that I'm interviewing. What the hell can I play on my playlist? And you guys are letting her listen to Cardi B?
As I said,
it's not that we're letting her listen to the music, innit? But at the end of the day, music is a thing where you just find, like, sometimes you gravitate towards different sounds and all of that. And it so happened that she loved Cardi B sound and all that, but I wouldn't let her listen to maybe potentially some lyrics we hear is a bit too explicit, you know. So I'm kind of mindful of that, you know. It's not that she's just free to her own devices.
But that's why I said lyrical ability. I said lyrical ability, not in terms of the stuff that she promotes and like you know, visually. But I definitely think she's a very talented artist in terms of lyrical ability.
Can I say something? And honestly, from the heart, I personally think you're better than Cardi B lyrically.
Thank you.
No, I do. Seriously. And I wouldn't say that to make, I would not say that to gas somebody up. And when it comes to, people don't really like me because I tell the truth about them lyrically. I'll be like, go home. It's not going to work. And they'll be like, no, but I'm the greatest rapper. Yeah, do you not hear that lyrics? And I'm like, no, it just didn't even rhyme, man. Like, so that's where we're living the century. And I really think you are better than Cardi B at 11 years old. So go for your great. And you know what? Whoever inspire you and whoever you do pick up influence from in life, that's all good. But try and pick up all the positives from them and not the negative crap that they also tag themselves along with. You know, because you're a growing woman, and two, it's up to your generation to make sure that generation is educated about real etiquette and real responsibility. You know what I mean? And the little things that your parents have left you that ingrained in you. You know what I'm saying? That you can't lose in the music industry or throughout money and fame. Yeah? You do sound like a really grounded girl. So I have no qualms with thinking that you're not going to make it or not going to go far and not going to influence people in the next 20 years to do big things and inspire a whole generation of women that are going to be inspired because of you. Trust me, this is facts. Yeah. So back to The Voice Kids real quick. Who did you see as, like, when you were looking at all the other kids and you were like, okay, these lot are good, who was you like worried about the most as far as, okay, I've got a really crunch, like, and do you know when you're coming up to performances, yeah? And then you had your performance locked down where you knew what you were about to go on stage, and then somebody else come and do something, and you're like, I wasn't ready for that. Who surprised you performance-wise?
I definitely think all of them surprised me, because, I mean, they're all individual artists, and they all did something very different, but they all kind of did the same thing because they were all singers. But, like, in terms of, they all stood out in a certain way. And I didn't see anyone as a threat. I see myself as an individual artist. I've just come here to do my thing, and I don't really want to worry about anyone else. Because, you know, if I did that, you know, I could get caught up and stuff and think mine's not good enough and things like that. But I just see it as I'm working on myself. This is for me and not for anybody else.
I really like that, and stay with that attitude. Don't care what people do. Trends come, trends go, but nobody can make you. Do you know what I'm saying? You're the trend. So right now, what's your biggest advice you would give to young people, kids, even adults? Because someone like you can actually advise some adults, you know? What is your biggest advice you would give to anyone who is trying to make it in the music industry and trying to think, okay, can I do this?
The main one would definitely be just to believe in yourself, because you're always going to get to a point where, should I do this? I don't know if this will be right. What if they think it's bad? What if it's not good enough? You have to just think about how you think it is. Like, if you think it's good, do it, because you think it's good. You don't have to worry about anybody else and what they're thinking.
Yeah, and are you going to tell them it is a very hard journey, though? It's not an overnight success thing that most people actually think, right? Everyone thinks that, oh, if I make one song, it's going to blow up, and that's not the case, right? How hard is it?
I have to say, it is extremely hard. I've been doing this for 6 years and I'm only 11. So that's kind of like, how long is it going to take, you know, just to get to the top? And that's all I really want to do. But I think, you know, I'm getting there step by step. And nothing comes overnight. You have to work for what you want. So I definitely think it's good what I'm doing.
Definitely, definitely is. So I'm going to try and play this song. Well, actually, first introduce the song and let them know where they can get it from. And also tell us about where you got the idea for this song and why you chose it to be the first to come out after The Voice Kids.
So I got this song because, like, mainly my daddy is always telling me I eat sweets too much and I need to stop. I need to stop because I have a very sweet tooth, which I agree with, you know, as you can see on my tooth. But I just love sweets. I've loved them all my life. And like sometimes I eat shakes,
big up Cleo,
kind of a lot in a day. So yeah, that's definitely where I got the idea from. I eat sweets a lot and I think a lot of other kids can relate to that. So yeah, that's why I got the idea. And what was the other question again?
What made you think of this being the first single after The Voice Kids to come out?
As I said, I thought it could, like, a lot of other kids could relate to it. And since I'm on The Voice Kids, I thought kids can relate. Also, I thought it would be very commercial because, you know, kids will be like, oh, mom, I like sweets. It's a little Shan Shan. I really like her style. Can you buy this for me? Like, on Spotify and stuff.
Little marketing. See, she's even got a marketing head on her head. That's why I asked her. So, what about your teeth? Let me see your teeth. Are they not falling out yet with the candy you eat? No, you should be worried though, because sweets do make little girls' teeth fall out, you know, and you don't want to be a rapper with no teeth. So, introduce the song real quick, because it's about to play.
This is Sweet Tooth by yours truly, Little Shan Shan. It's now out on all digital platforms, and make sure you go stream it and download it. And yeah.
Shan Shan. On team, will I am.
Yeah.
Give me some candy. Give me some candy now.
I don't run out of battery. Supply the room like a factory. Sweet tooth full of candy. Said sweet tooth full of candy. I don't run out of battery. Supply the room like a factory. Sweet tooth full of candy. Sweet tooth full of candy. Big bars, do you like it? My verse, you recite it. Bear fans are excited. I see the future like psychic. You talk it, you hype it. I talk it, you type it. I do something, you mime it. I got skills, I apply it. Me and Pop doing mileage. Couple ladies on the signage. You try be me, I'm out shining. We got cool to the climbing. Cause sometimes we out eating dinner. Sometimes we out dining. Cause sometimes we out eating dinner. Sometimes we out dining. I don't run out of battery. Supply the room like a factory. Sweet tooth full of candy. Said sweet tooth full of candy. I don't run out of battery. Supply the room like a factory. Sweet tooth full of candy. Said sweet tooth full of candy. Candy. I love candy. I love candy.
Mad.
Every day I am writing, spitting bars that you're liking. They're outdated like Viking, my bars will strike you like lightning. I'm only here to enlighten, and every day I am rising. All the time I'm reviving.
How come I have not got the MP3 to this?
Every time I come a girl, can't set it, then I gotta go, and then I gotta get it, then I gotta go, and then I gotta show a girl. Everything I'm doing is it just really matter, cause of that, yeah. Every time I come a girl, can't set it, then I gotta go, and then I gotta get it, then I gotta go, and then I gotta show a girl. Everything I'm doing is it just really matter, cause of that. I don't run out of battery. Supply the room like a factory. Sweet tooth full of candy. Said sweet tooth full of candy. I don't run out of battery. Supply the room like a factory. Sweet tooth full of candy. Said sweet tooth full of candy. I love candy.
So let me know who produced this record.
I love candy.
This one was produced by Will.i.am. Yeah, he made the beat, and I'm very thankful for that. So big up to Will. Yeah, thank you.
That's crazy. So your experience working on with Will.i.am on this record, and let us know about how it was in the studio with him and all that.
I got to learn a lot of things, like especially seeing him, how he made the beat. I'm definitely not a pro at making beats or anything like that. But I definitely like learned some things off of him. He gave me a lot of key advice, like how to kind of position when you're recording. And he also really bigged me up because he was like, a lot of people take a really long time to record in the studio. But with me, I just done it in one take. So I'm very proud of myself for that, not going to lie.
One take? What? That's Jay-Z status, you know. That's Jay-Z status right there. What? One take? That's mad. So how many songs did you make with Will.i.am?
Only one. That's the one that he produced and everything like that.
Nice. Have you got anything? What's your next song coming out? Do you know yet, or are you still planning that?
I can't disclose that right now, but just know big things are coming up.
So, do you freestyle on beats, or do you freestyle a cappella? What do you do?
I'm very versatile. I can do anything.
What do you want to do?
I don't mind.
I'm not trying to put you in a position, you know. So, what would you like to do? A cappella, or do you want to do a beat? No. What would be more fun to for you? A beat or a cappella? What do you guys think? Whew. Yeah? That's cool. Alright. What do you think of this? What do you think of this? You like it? Alright. So this beat's by Onyx. Do you remember this one, Tanda?
What?
It had sticky fingers on this. Oh, hey.
Yeah. Little Shan Shan. I didn't know the beat had dropped, but it's cool. Yeah.
Do you know what? I'm going to rewind this because I want you to really introduce yourself properly and then go into this and enjoy it. Just enjoy it, yeah?
Little Shen Shen. Sweet Tooth out now. All digital outlets. Make sure you go check it out. Yeah. Back to the future like Martin McFly. I stay high in my air nights, rocking the mic. I spit a Sage 16, ain't no need to try. I am so intelligent, chatting is irrelevant. Living in my bars just like I was a resident. I am so sick, so I don't know what you're telling them. I'm above average, so you know that I will never spit bars. We don't pull up in prompts, but a couple dumb girls just pull up and dance. And I ain't Eminem, but I'm taking that chance. You okay? How you doing, man? I'm having a blast. Got a skate, I gotta go back to class. Blowing bars fast, like I was mowing the grass. We don't do no frauds like Nicki Minaj. Little kid, big money, man, I'm living it large. Yeah.
What? Yo. That was crazy. That was like, literally better than most these. Again, how many people think that she's better than Cardi B in the studio? Let me know. Everyone? Out of all the people, we've got 90% of the studios claiming that she's better than Cardi B. Yo, Little Shan Shan is the one person you guys have got to go out and look out for no matter what. She has this single out called Sweet Tooth, which is available on YouTube. The music video is also available on Spotify, Apple Music, Tidal, all digital stores. Big up Anne, Touch Magazine, One Extra in the building. Big up Tunder, 57 Dynasty. Big up Shan Shan's big brother. You want to say something?
I don't mind. Little Shaq, I'm an upcoming artist as well.
Can you drop a freestyle on this? All right, you know what I want to do? All right, if you don't mind, Shan Shan. No, where are you going? Course. All right, so we're going to drop this again, and I want you two to drop a freestyle. Is that possible? Yeah? Come in. All right, yeah. This is how we make some... Oh, yeah, let them know what you've got coming up. And also, check out this black box thing that he showed me. It's really, really cool. Let them know.
All right, then. So you guys, firstly, you can go add me up on Instagram. My Instagram is LIL_SHAKZZ. My black box is out right now. Little Shat's black box. A video coming very, very soon, hopefully on GRM, called Dead It. So, I mean, yeah, there's a lot coming soon. So, yeah, let me hit them with a freestyle, show them what I'm capable of.
So, we got Little Shan Shan in the building. We've got, what's your name again, sorry? Yeah. Little Shaq's in the building. This is like next generation 57 Dynasty coming to you right now live. Like,
you don't know the levels of what's going on right now. Shan, have you rapped with your brother live on TV or radio or anything yet? Okay, duet song. Is it out yet?
No.
It's not out yet. All right, so bang. You guys ready? Let me just chuck this all out of the way. I don't know what the hell it's doing covering you lot. All right, so going. Just sorry about that. We're going live on my Facebook too. Mad things that have to happen right now. All right, so we got Little Shanshan from the final of The Voice UK Kids. We've got Little Shax, who's her big brother, and they're about to drop it like this.
Start if you want.
Yo, yo, oh, Little Shax. Yo, what? Yo, you can't compare to me, I'm too damn original, lyrical criminal, young black individual. I'm not your average, I ain't never been your typical. You can never be me, you're just too despicable. Shutting down shows and they're thinking it's a miracle. I can do this at my minimal. I'm that boss at the end, I'm just so unkillable. Going to my pinnacle, my flow irresistible. Yo, let's go again, yo.
DJ Sin.
Yo, you can't compare to me, I'm too damn original, lyrical criminal, young black individual. I'm not your average, I ain't never been your typical. You can never be me, you're just too despicable. Shutting down shows and they're thinking it's a miracle. I can do this at my minimal. I'm that boss at the end, I'm just so unkillable. Going to my pinnacle, my flow irresistible. Yo, going in hard, and we're only children. When they hear my lyrics, they wanna steal them. Name a rapper in my ear, I'll kill them. Not literally, I'm just talking lyrically. When they hear my lyrics, yeah, they wanna mimic me. Going to the top, yeah, no one can limit me. Flow so cold, we're flowing in a symmetry. Got metaphors and similes.
Ready for this one, yeah?
Big pun, I'm bouncing back just like a boomerang. Trying to get the money, get the cream like the Wu-Tang. Baddest in the game, no rapper puts me to shame. If you come out of your lane, I'll put you back in your place. Yeah, I'm the best and they know I'm so original. Hear words clear and I'm pronouncing every syllable. Finest, I'm the greatest, be the opposite of quizzical. Fight for the throne, even if it gets physical. Lyrical assassin, got something that they just haven't. I've been putting in the passion while following the fashion. Suffering and struggling, you know I got compassion. And yeah, I made a loss, but my name ain't like to fluff in. Yeah.
Hey, this is crazy, man. You lot are talented. So, yo, real quick, London better wake up. Stop selling music that is whack. Time to bring real music back. Give Simon Cowell the sack and all these pop idols an attack. I'm about to sell like crack. On the crack, keep getting dispersed to the blacks and everyone ethnic getting capped. So we stay strapped. Of course I got a spare for my flat. Nada but the facts on these tracks. You picture me on rims. YDS embroidered on my Tims. And people can't see me through my tints. This is London Hot Radio. This is an exclusive. You're going to find this live everywhere. Big up Little Shanshan, big up Little Shax. Go check out their music on YouTube. Go check out their music on Spotify. Big congratulations to Little Shanshan for being a finalist at The Voice Kids UK. Go check out and support her. Keep sharing this. You know it is what it is. London Hot Radio.
DJ Sin.
Any shout outs you guys want to give before we go, by the way?
I just like to give a big shout out to my dad, because if it wasn't for him, me and Shax wouldn't be doing any of this. Also, I would like to give a big shout out to Shax, my older brother. He's definitely inspiring as well, because when I see him writing bars, I feel like, you know, I'm obliged to write bars as well. So thank you, Shax.
So yeah, give a big up to dad, and then give a big up to London Hot Radio for bringing us in today. So yeah, man. Do you want us to hit it one more time? Should we hit it again, yeah?
Do you want another beat or do you want the same beat? No, it's up to you guys. Yeah? All right, so you guys keep talking, keep bigging up people until I find another beat real quick.
So yeah, my black box out right now, as I said, LILSHAKZ, just write black box at the end. And yeah, that's out and I got a video coming very, very soon. So yeah,
And as I said before, guys, make sure you follow me on my social medias. Instagram is lilshan_shan, spell LILSHAN _SHAN. My Twitter is I'm Little Shan Shan. And my Facebook is the same as my Instagram, lilshan_shan, LILSHAN_SHAN. And my TikTok is the same, lilshan_shan. So yeah, guys.
So I found the instrumental. It is 8 minutes to the ad breaks. We are going to close it off with these two doing a quick another freestyle. Remember, go find them, go share their music, and go support them. We're going to break it off later. We're going to make it a little bit more fun right now.
Another old school one, yeah? Yo. Yo. Let me go. Yo. See, everybody on this world's got a deception. I got love for this music thing, so I be out here trying to show my affection. Remember them days I was sat in reception, didn't ever think that I would know about the tension. When I'm in school, it's the knowledge that I'm fetching. Not trying to be like these youths on the road shutting crow, and after 3 weeks they be flexing. See, that lifestyle, yeah, it ain't for me. Writing all these tracks, I'm as busy as a bee. Got bare hooks like Muhammad Ali. See, I'm out here really trying to make that pee. Got enough love for my family. Yeah, I'm gonna make it, never coming basic. If life was a race, I would race it. See the gold medal at the end of the race, I would take it. I just been feeling low sometimes. That's just the way life goes sometimes. I just been feeling low sometimes. Yeah.
He even dropped us with a chorus, you know. Yeah.
DJ Sin.
Yeah. Big bars, what they're saying, it's irrelevant, it's evident. I'm better than the league with the rest of them. Yes, I'm in my own league, I'm the president. People trying to be in the lies, but cannot find the evidence. I can't back, but at least I talk intelligence. If you want to stay in my team, you be labeled as the resident. Say it with my elegance, baddest in the village, so they calling me your elephant. E=MC², but I'm bringing all the energy while walking up the stairs. And I be counting out my stocks while sharing out my shares. I know I'm getting big, but I've been doing this for years. Yeah.
Hit the beat one more time, it's too cold, man. Yo, what? New type of beat, told Dan I'm gonna try it. Her two bars, now she said she wanna buy it. This is the life I wanna live, I can't really fight it. She'll eat, give me sugar when she listen to my no diet. That was the old thing, had to bring a new style. Bopping through the road, never keep it old town. Making music, they be calling me a soul child. Everybody wanna connect, I'm like a mobile. Originality, bringing all the clarity. Know that I'm better than you, but why you mad at me? I be setting trends and these brothers keep catting me. Never slacking me, I just keep on rapping G. Do it rapidly, happily, go into my capacity. Rap is my personality. Personality, all for my family. Yeah, all for my family. What? All for my family.
Yeah,
DJ Sin.
Wait for the beat to drop again. Oh, yeah, let me hear it again. Don't worry. Yeah.
Shan locking it off. So make sure you go catch these two kids. This is the last Shan freestyle she's giving you. You know. Hey, make sure you guys catch these two kids out there. Go support them. Out.
Yeah. DJ Sin.
Three, two, one, and got my shakes up, but I don't need a bar. But you're looking all slim and you're looking all mager. Name's all Shan, so you know I ain't Cara. Getting bare views that my name's Ariana. No, I gotta work, but I'm not Rihanna. Times get rough like we're living in Gaza. See me? I'm hot like lava. Ain't in no palaver. Your lip look dry like cassava. Ain't no little girl like me going in harder. Lil Shan, I'm hot like sun. I flow like what? I'm a human. What I gotta do to get it pretty? I'm superhuman. Yeah.
DJ Sin.
You might be superhuman. You know? You might be superhuman. All right, Shan, Little Shat, go check them out. Make sure you go follow them on Instagram. What is your Instagram again?
LIL_SHAKZZ. That's a little underscore shacks.
And what is yours?
LilShan_Shan. That is spelled LILSHAN_SHAN. Thank you for having us today.
Thank you.
No problem. And you know what? I hope you guys had a great evening. I hope you guys enjoyed that. Go share it. And you are listening to
LondonHotRadio.com. Tune in now for shout outs and requests. Call, WhatsApp, or SMS us on 0044 777 060324.